Lord, yes, Lord. When I was hearing that song earlier this week, I was thinking about all God had brought me through over the couple of months. And right this morning at 3:15, God gave me what he wanted me to tell his people. And God said, you go into Job and tell them the situation Job went through. Because you just came through a Job situation. I said, okay, God. And if I brought you through before, remember, I'll bring you through again. And I'm standing here on God's word. And saying to God, all God wants us to do this day is trust him. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, as we come before you this morning, Father God, first of all, as I come before you this morning to deliver your word to your people, I ask you to move self out the way. I ask you, Father God, to increase your spirit in me and decrease my flesh. I ask you, Father God, to bless the ones that's here. Bless the ones that's on their way. Look upon Pastor and the First Lady, Father God. Bless their family. Cover, Father God, and protect them continually with your blood. Look upon the deacons, the mothers, the elders. Father God, the world as a whole. Look upon the ones that's here, Father God. Touch every need that they are in need of this morning. Bless right now. Take this word, Father God, and use it as you see fit. These and other blessings I ask you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. If you will, get your word to my pastor, First Lady, Elder Evans, Elder May, all the deacons and mothers, and to all of God's children. Good morning. And I'll be coming from this morning, Job, the first chapter, 20 through the 22nd. Job, the first chapter, 20 through the 22nd. And it reads, then Job arose, tore his robe, and shaved his head. And he fell to the ground and worshiped. And he said, naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In all this, Job did not sin, nor charge God with wrong. Amen. Saint Job was a just man, wealthy, was blameless, and feared God. A man that lost everything, all 10 children, his home, ox, cattle, everything was taken away from Job. Everything except his soul. Can you imagine? Not one casket laying before the altar, but 10 children he had to bury. My God, Job wasn't standing on the material things that God had given him, but the faith, the trust that he had in God. Out of all he endured, Job never once turned from his faith, stopped trusting in God. He believed with all his being that God was more than enough. See, we have to get to that situation in our lives. No matter what it look like in the natural realm, we have to get to the situation to know that God is more than enough. Job didn't let nothing or no one separate him from the love of God. Even when his wife came along and told him to curse God and die, Job told her, you talk like a foolish woman. He wasn't going to curse God because he knew the God that he served was more than enough. Amen? And I'm going to go back. I don't even know if I even told you my text. My scripture is coming from Job, but my text is not my will, but God will be done. And for a subtopic, learn to trust in God. Not my will, but God will be done. Now see, at that moment when she told Job to curse God and die, in other words, Job was telling her, not my will, but God's will be done. Job didn't understand what he was going through, why he was tested, but God knew. He even asked, he told Satan, have you tried my servant Job? And Satan did everything he could to break him. But God told him, you can touch his material things. You can even touch his fleshly body. But don't touch his soul. All right. All right. And that's what Job stood on. Out of everything the enemies tried to break him, he couldn't break his soul. And see, we got to get there, saints. No matter what come our way, our soul got to be anchored in the Lord. Amen. Material things gonna fade away. This fleshly body gonna turn back to dust. But your soul will reign with God. Amen. We have to be encouraged and pray for one another. And stand still and wait on God. No matter how hard it gets, because it's gonna get harder. Satan didn't curse God. And it's going to get time in our life. We might question God. Yes, we might question him when the enemy come our way. Saints, don't you know that fasting and prayer is not just for a season? That's something we should do all the time. Because we are not so holy, nor are we perfect. You pray because you need the Lord every day. You pray because you need the Lord every day. You fast when you're seeking God for a blessing. When you're fasting and praying for someone else. You fast, you lay down things that you desire to get an answer from God. And that's something we should do at least every week if we can. Set aside some time and fast. Amen. Job was a yes man, an upright man, a faithful man in all his ways, yes. And that's where we should be saying to ourselves, I'm a just woman, I'm a faithful woman, I'm an upright woman in the eyesight of the Lord. Amen? A man that showed who he really was in the eyesight of God. And when God looked down on us, we should say this, want God to say the same thing. A man and a woman that show who we really are in the eyesight of God. At the time of his children's death, he could have been sad. He could have cursed God. He could have gotten jealous and wished that that was somebody else that lost everything and everybody. But he didn't. He didn't do none of that. But because of the anointing, he was secure. He was too gifted to be jealous, saints. He was too blessed to be sad. See, some of us are so gifted, so anointed, that we forget where the gifts and the anointing came from. All of that came from God, amen? In the midst of his trial, in the midst of his test, he didn't forget where all of that came from. He knew who gave him all those material things. He was so wealthy, he didn't know what to do with everything. Like some of us today, we have too much glory on our life to wish we was somebody else, to wish we was in somebody else's shoes. We don't know what they went through to get the glory on their life. We don't know what they went through to be driving a Benz. So why would we be jealous of what they got? Who knows what y'all went through to get all of that wealth? Who knows how many times he got up, fast, and prayed, and laid before God and consecrated himself to get where he was. Amen? Some of us need God to make us whole again. Take us back to the place where we first received him. Amen? Take us back to the place where we was broken. To the place where we humbled ourselves, laid before God, consecrated ourselves, fast and prayed, and wasn't ashamed to cry out before God. Some of us need that. Amen? Don't ever be ashamed to cry before God. Don't ever be ashamed to stand and tell the Lord, I'm sorry. Repent. Amen. Take us back to the place where we first trusted him. When we was broken, when we trusted him. When we was lonely, we trusted him. No food on the table, we trusted him. We need to ask God to take us back to that place where we can seek his face. Turn from our wicked ways. Seek his face. Take us back to the place when we was broke, busting, and disgusted. We didn't have nobody to trust and lean on but God. See, God will put you in a situation where money can't get you out, people can't get you out, nor material things can get you out. Nobody but God can bring you through it. And when he puts you in that situation, that's when you're broken. That's when he got you exactly where he wants you. Now you're going to have to turn to me. Now you're going to have to humble yourself. And it's a sad thing God have to put us there. But if it get our attention to break us, to put us there, do it. That's what I told him. That's what it takes to get me where I need to be, Lord. I'm broken. I'm humble. I'm where I need to be. In the midst of a storm, we must learn to trust God. Just like Job, though he may slay some of us, yet will we trust him. Will we trust him, saints? Trust him with our giving. Pay our tithes and offering. Give God what due him first. God said the first of the week when we get paid, 10% belong to him. 10%, all he asking for, belong to him. Trust him with your prayer. Because the reason some of us survive some of the things that we've been through, the reason that we still here today, not because we are something special, because in the eyes of the God, we nothing. But because the God we serve is special. Amen? And if God be for you, saints, who in the world can be against you? Whatever the situation, whatever the condition, whatever the pain that you're facing today, there's a name greater, and that name is Jesus. I learn in my spirit, I learn in my soul, and I lift him up daily that nobody is greater. Nobody is greater than Jesus. His name, saints of God, is above all names. And he's worthy of all our praise. Nobody greater. Can you just put that song in your spirit and just think on that? Nobody greater than Jesus. Some of the things that we're going through is all in God's plan. See, sometimes God will send us through situations to mold us, to shape us, to be the woman of God and the man of God that we was called to be, that we was born to be. We wasn't just born to be who we want to be, but we was born to be who God called us to be. Amen? Will he fail us? No. Will he come through in time of need? Yes. Will he provide? Yes. Because I believe, and I'm still standing, not just because of the belief I have in God, but because of the God that I serve. I believe that the blood, saints of God, that the blood that God shed on Calvary, the blood that God shed on Calvary, the blood that gives me strength from day to day, it will never, saints of God, lose its power. And at that time when Job was going through his test, his so-called friends came along, questioned him, asking him, in other words, what did you do, man, to go through this? Did you curse God? Did you do something wrong? You had to have done something for God to allow this to happen to you. You see what kind of so-called friends they were? See, we have to be watch those dogs now. You got to be careful of them so-called friends. You really do. You have to pray for a friend. And in the midst of that, Job continually read the book of Job, stood on the word of God, ministered to them over and over again. Jehovah Jireh this, Jehovah Jireh that. He stood on the word. But now here come another one telling them, no, man, you had to have done something. So I'm bringing it down to your level, not the way the Bible got it. You had to have done something. There's no way God allowed this to happen to you. Do you see yourself? You land here with sores on you, boys, you wrapped up in napkins, you bleeding, and you sitting there talking about the God that you serve? Really? And at the end, when God spoke to him, God took those same so-called friends and had them to turn around and bless him with double for his trouble. He turned around and gave him 10 children back, more cattle. I mean, he was more wealthy at the end than he was at the beginning. That's because he stood on the word of God. That's because it wasn't his will to go through that, but God's will, not mine, Lord, whatever your will is. And he stood and he went through that. He endured it. He endured that pain. He endured that hardship. He endured the cursing and the fussing and the friends coming along, backbiting and talking about him, making him feel less than a man. Can you imagine him laying there already going through the loss of everything? And his wife walked away, didn't understand why he didn't curse God and die. Can you imagine what he just endured? And could any of us now endure all of that and not curse God? I don't know if our faith prayers need to be. If it's not, today is the day to surrender and ask God, God, if I'm not where I need to be, place me in the place where I need to be. Get me there, Lord. Search my heart and see that I trust you. Search my thoughts and see that I'm where I need to be. Lord, I might not be all I need to be in your eyesight, but I'm willing to do your will. Not my will, Lord God, but thy will be done. Lord, I want to trust you, but there's some things in the way. Ask God to move them. Ask God to move anything, anybody, any situation that's a hinder to your spirit, that's a hinder to your walk with him. I promise you he'll do it. He'll do it. It might be some lonely days, but he'll do it. It might be some lonely nights, but he will do it, saints. You got to learn to trust him. You got to learn to stand on his word. You got to learn to believe that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. As long as you stay with God, I promise you, things gonna get hard sometimes. But know that I know that I know. There's a God that sits high and look low. He will bring you through it. He will bring you through it, saints. He will never leave you, nor will he forsake you. There's a God that sits high, sees and hears every prayer that you pray. You might not think God hear you because your prayers haven't been answered today, but he hear you. God didn't say his timing was our timing. But he's going to answer your prayers. I want you to be encouraged this morning to know that the things that you have prayed for, the things that you are waiting on, they coming. They coming, but they coming in his timing. They coming when he's ready. Not our will, but his will be done. But in his timing. There are some things I'm waiting on. One thing in particular. And I wish it had just happened just like that. But it's not in my timing, it's in his timing. And when it happened, it's gonna happen. I just have to trust God. I have to wait on God. But I know in my heart it's coming. When? I don't know. Because that's not how God works. Once you pray and tell God what you want, lay it before the altar, leave it there. But you're constantly getting up worried, Lord, I asked you for this 2 months ago. And here it is, I still don't have it. Lord might want to give it to you next year at the right time, the right place, the right season. Because right now you might not be strong enough in your spirit. You might not be woman or man enough to handle it, to endure it. At that season when Job went through that situation, he had to be ready for it, because God wouldn't allow the enemy to touch him if he wasn't ready and strong enough to endure that. God already knew. He even told the devil, have you tried my servant Job? And Satan looked at him like, okay, he took everything. I'll try just to show you that he'll curse you. And when he tried him, Job continually stood on the word of God over and over and over until it got to the end when God finally responded back to him. Because he got to the point, I think in the midst of that, Job kind of got weak when he was asking God these questions. Even when he told the Lord when he wanted to die and return back. But he never cursed God. He never denied who God was in his life. And God told him, you didn't make none of this. I made all of this. You didn't make it rain. You didn't make the sun. I made all of this. When he finally answered Job and told him all of those things, that's when Job repented, surrendered, and told the Lord. He understood. But after he repented for feeling like he was feeling in his spirit, that's when God stepped in and gave him double for his trouble. And see, when we get to the point that we done did all we can do, tried it the way we want to try, step back, let go, and tell the Lord, not my will, Lord God, but thy will be done. I'm taking my hands off. I'm tired. I done did all I can do. I done said all I can say. Now it's all on you. And when you lay it there, get up and go on about your business. Leave it there. Really, really leave it there. And watch God show up. Watch him show up. And when he show up, he's going to turn it around in such an awesome way. It's going to surprise you and your so-called friends. See, his so-called friends couldn't say nothing when God turned around and blessed him double. I wish it was another part to that after he was blessed double for his trouble. I would love to see what happened to those so-called friends, how they reacted when they had to turn around and give him cattle and ox and all of that. Just get into the book of Job. It's amazing me sometime when you read some of those stories and how God brought them through all of those hard times and trials and tested their faith. The same thing he's doing to us today. But we're going to have to learn to get just that rooted in his word, rooted in his faith, and stand and believe that if he did it then, he'll do it again. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you, and you have a wonderful day. Amen.